These amino acids classified into two types based on their availability in living organism body, especially living organism body means in human beings. They are essential amino acids, essential amino acids, and next one is non-essential amino acids. The two types of amino acids, all the 20 amino acids just written on the board. So out of all these 20, some of them are called as essential amino acids, some of them are called as non-essential amino acids. So what are essential amino acids? I was given just now, all 20 types of amino acids never biosynthesized by animal body, inside of the animal body. So for that, some of them, whatever the amino acids never biosynthesized in living organism body, especially animal body, we have to take such amino acids from outside of the body through diet. Such amino acids are called as essential amino acids. So whereas what are non-essential amino acids? Some of the amino acids out of the 20 are biosynthesized in our body. So such type of amino acids no need to take outside of the body through diet. So such amino acids are called as non-essential amino acids. Once again, a simple difference between essential and non-essential. Those amino acids which are not biosynthesized in our body, we have to take outside of the body. We have to take them through diet outside of our body are called as essential amino acids. Whereas some of them are biosynthesized themselves, biosynthesized in our body. So such type of amino acids no need to take from outside of our body. So such type of amino acids are called as non-essential amino acids. Here examples for some examples for essential amino acids are histidine, methionine, valine, leucine, isoleucine, lysine, tyrosine, tryptophan, etc. So these are not biosynthesized in a living organism body or especially in animal body. So in such case, these amino acids, definitely we require such type of amino acids. So these amino acids we have to take through diet. Whereas the remaining amino acids like glycine, alanine, glutamic acid, glutamine, etc. So glutamic acid, glutamine, arginine, aspartic acid, all these, proline, etc. These are biosynthesized in animal body. So we need not to take them through outside of our body. So this is the reason why they are called as non-essential amino acids. So this is the first type of classification of amino acids, essential amino acids and non-essential amino acids. And one more type of classification, we can classify the amino acids into neutral amino acids. This is one. The second one, basic amino acids. Third one, acidic amino acids. One type of classification based on their availability, essential amino acids, non-essential amino acids, In another type, we can classify the amino acids into three categories: neutral amino acids, basic amino acids, acidic amino acids. Once again, what are amino acids? Each amino acids have to consist of minimum of one acid functional group, one amino functional group. So those amino acids in which one amino group and one carboxylic acid group present. That means not more than one amine, not more than one acid functional group. Only they have to be with one amino group, one acid group. Then the resulting amino acids are called as neutral amino acids. So amino group, generally amino group is basic functional group and carboxylic acid functional group is acidic functional group. So one basic functional group and one acidic functional group is present, one basic and one acidic, the resulting amino acid will become neutral. It is not basic and it is not neutral. Similarly, out of the above statements are above available amino acids, 20 naturally available amino acids, some of the amino acids are having more than one amino group but only one COOH carboxylic acid group. So just observe here, as I just told you, NH2 is amino group which is basic and COOH is carboxylic acid group. This is acid. When the considered amino acid having one amino group and one acid group, the resulting will become neutral. But some of the amino acids stated, they are having more than one basic functional group but only one acidic functional group, then the resulting character identified with amino acids are basic in character. Due to presence of excess amount of basic groups, that is amino groups, the resulting amino acids are also basic in nature. Whereas acidic amino acids, just opposite to this, they are with one amino group, that is basic group, and more than one COOH group.